Thank you, Jesus. There's a burning fire in our heart that makes us take this mission as our life. Amen. Let's look at Romans chapter 10, verse 12. No preacher, no rescue. No preacher, no rescue. Romans chapter 10, from verse 12 to 14. Let's read. Are we there? From verse 12 to 14, let's read. It says, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How then shall they call on him on whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a word, a preacher? It does not say how shall they hear without God. It does not say how shall they hear. The most vital variable now is the preacher, because Christ has already finished everything. So the preacher is vital and extremely vital in the equation of salvation. Without us, men will be lost. If we decide to keep quiet with the gospel, men will be lost. Men will be condemned. Men that would have been saved. So we must have compassion on the lost. we are men, because we have the Spirit of God, we are not trying to drag God's desire and make it our own. It is already our nature by the virtue of the fact that we have the Holy Spirit. So God's desire is our desire. Say, God's desire is my desire. God's passion is my passion. God's compassion is my compassion. Let's look at Matthew chapter 9 verse 37. We have compassion on the ignorant. We have compassion on the lost. We feel the pain of ignorance on their behalf. So we don't live for ourselves. We take God's call serious. Matthew chapter 9 from verse 37. Let's start from 35. It says, and Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Amen. So the motivation that Jesus had for his ministry was compassion. That is, he was not doing it because he wanted to show off. He was not doing it because he was just having one zeal that was not of God. The zeal that he had was that same compassion that God had. We saw in 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 3 that he wants all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. So us, we as believers, we also we carry that same compassion. When we see a man that doesn't know Christ, we don't bypass them. Amen. Amen. We don't turn a blind eye. We don't turn a blind eye to the ignorant. We don't turn a blind eye to the dark places of the earth. We don't turn a blind eye to the places where ignorance has built a stronghold. We feel compassion for them, and that moves us, that drives us, because we know that without us, God does nothing. Without us, nothing will happen when as touching the salvation of men. Amen. Let's continue. He now said, verse 37, he said, then said he unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers. Amen. So we see the same thing we've been seeing, consistent. He said that Jesus had compassion on them. But he didn't say, okay, since I have compassion, I can do it. I can do it by myself. I don't need anybody. He spoke to his disciples. He said that the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. So that means the laborer is vital. The laborer here is the same thing as the preacher in Romans chapter 10, right? So the laborer is vital. And we are those laborers. Have compassion in our hearts for the ignorant. Amen. We take God's desire. We take the Father's call. We take the Father's call with responsibility and urgency, because we are responsible sons. We feel God's passion in our hearts. We feel God's fire in our hearts for the gospel. Amen. Lastly, let's look at Romans chapter 9. Shut up, Romans chapter 9. From verse 1. It says, I say the truth in Christ, I lie not, my conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I could wish that myself were accursed from Christ for my brethren, my kinsmen according to the flesh. Amen. Look at what he said there in verse 2. He said he has great heaviness and continual sorrow in his heart. That is, this is a man that God's passion for souls has also consumed him. When he saw his brethren, the Israelites, when he saw that they are lost, they are ignorant of the goodness of God in the gospel, he says he has great heaviness and continual sorrow in his heart. Amen. So as we go out with the work of the gospel, we are full of an urgency. When men are seeing greed, when they are greedy and all that is in their eyes is money, for us, all that we see in our eyes is souls. Say souls. We see souls. We see souls. We are hungry. Once we see a man, we don't start calculating, how can I get this man's money now? What doctrine will I preach to bring his money? No, we think of the Father's desire immediately. There's a passion in us for the gospel. Amen. Let's lift our hands and sing in the Holy Ghost. Shalala, shalala. calling out with open arms. He wants to save the world. So let us go for and rescue the children who are lost with open arms. We have to save the world. We are the move. We are the move of the Spirit. The Father is at work when we pray.
And when we preach the word.
When we preach the word.
We have to save the world.
have to go. We have to save the world.
One more time.
We have to be the soul.
The Father is counting.
The Father is counting.
We have to go.
We have to go. We have to save the world. When we pray,
and when we preach,
and when we preach the word,
we are the move of His Spirit.
We are the move of His Spirit. The Father is at work.
When we pray,
when we pray,
and when we preach,
and when we preach the word,
just sing in the Holy Ghost and yield yourself. Lift your hands and say, Father, I'm committed. I hear what you call for. I yield to it. I yield to it. I run with your message. Because I am the move of the Spirit. I am the move of the Spirit. The responsibility of the gospel is on my shoulders. Necessity is laid upon me. Woe is me if I don't preach. I have to preach. I have to preach. We pray. We preach. We are the move of the Spirit. Shatala maraka to shabraka taka ba 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 ba. Shatabraka to shabraka ba 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 ba. Shana mananos. Shatabraka ba 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 nos. Shatabraka ba 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 nos. Shana brana ba nos. Shatabraka ba 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 nos. Shana mana ba 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 nos. Shakata mando shabraka ba ba ba. Shabraka ba 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 ba. I hear a sound in the Spirit. Is the Father calling out with open arms? He wants to save the world. So let us go.
So let us go far and rescue the children who are lost with open arms. We have to say, we have to save the world.
Because we are the move of the Spirit.
We are the move. The Spirit, the Father is at work. When we pray,
and when we preach,
and when we preach the word,
move.
We are the move of the Spirit. The Father is at work. When we pray,
and when we preach,
and when we preach the word.
Hallelujah. Let's take up our Bibles. Thank you, Jesus.